Hello, welcome back to Jakey's Pod. This is my third solo episode, none of which have been released, none of which have been edited or even listened to. Right now, I am en route. Well, let me just say it's the date. Today is March. Today is a Tuesday in March. And I'm off to do some comedy. I'm off to do some Tuesday night comedy. There's a lot of comedy. Wow, that is a nice park. It's beautiful out today. It is a beautiful day. I see the breeders are out at the park teaching their children to play basketball, teaching them to look at stuff and talk to dogs, exercise, all that. All that stuff. God, I kind of want my window open. It's probably going to make the audio sound worse than it is already, so but fuck it. Have not listened back to the solo episodes. I have the feeling that they're crazy. I have the feeling that they're insane. I was talking, so my birthday was this week. My birthday was this Sunday. Good birthday. Excellent birthday. In terms of like the day, it was an excellent birthday. I did everything I wanted to do. Like from midnight to midnight, did everything I wanted to do. But I was talking to my mom during that day, and we always have a nice birthday phone call if we can't see each other. And she was like, as a baby, we would talk about you. And we would talk about what kind of, we were so curious what kind of man you were gonna grow up to be. What kind of man you're gonna grow up to be. And she was like, and now you're almost 30 and you're fucking nuts. As my mother called me nuts on my birthday. Can you believe that? And you know what? She's true. She's correct. You know, I mean, these solo episodes might be fucking just too much. Too much. Maybe I don't release them. Maybe I do. Maybe I don't. Maybe I do. But yeah, she said I'm not. And that's funny to me because I feel like only my friends, once they really know me, once people, like if you've just met me and you think I'm kind of kooky, regular, you know, it's the people who really know me. Know that I'm truly insane. Shawnee says it all the time when he brings me up on stage. This guy's actually nuts. Oh, shit. Got the world's warmest Coors Light in my fucking car. Brendan Burroughs drinks Coors. I was just going to say, who drinks Coors Light? I guess Brendan Burroughs drinks Coors Light. But right, yeah, today's Tuesday. I'm freshly 29. I'm feeling 29. I'm about to go hit some sweet, sweet Philadelphia open mic comedy. Gotta smoke weed in front of a cop. Smoking weed right in front of a cop. You know. Do you want to know? The date is March something. March something, 2024. Do you want to know how many open mics there are in Philadelphia on a Tuesday night? I think five. I think the correct answer is five. There's five open mics tonight. Comedy is hot, baby. Comedy is on fire. Usually, I would usually do my classic Tuesday triple scramble. Well, my classic Tuesday triple scramble. Well, Tuesday hat trick. But, you know, I'm going to go to Helium tonight. I'm going to go to Helium, try to get on the list. I feel like I've forgotten all year. I feel like I planned my Tuesday so poorly. And every time I look on the internet, and I'll go, oh, there's the open mic. Oh, it already happened. And I always forget. This is going to sound pretty fucked up, but getting out of the house, it's 5:37. Getting out of the house before 6 o'clock for Jakey, that's a fucking tall order, all right? It's hard. I do most of my stuff in the middle of the day or at night, you know? Like last night, I was up till 4 or 5 in the morning. I was maybe doing work, real work, You know, in the relative sense. Oh, hold on, we got one of those music trikes coming by. Hey. Do you think they're gonna be mad if they? This is a good song. This is a good song. These guys are gonna kill me if they look over and see me jamming out. You guys could go. No, you guys go. You guys are rocking out. No, you go. You go, I insist. Absolutely ruining my podcast with that garbage rap music. I don't know who that was. Bah, bah, bah. It might be him. That might be the guy. You tell that guy likes Meek Mill. Can you believe all this Meek Mill is gaining? I saw somebody, I couldn't even bring myself to watch it. I couldn't even bring myself to watch it. Somebody did an animation on YouTube, I guess, about Meek Mill being gay with Diddy. And I'm like, I can't with this. What, Meek Mill has got to be so upset about the, by this. Wherever he is fucking not chilling. Do you know what I mean? Just people have, like, and you know what's the thing? This is what sucks about gay rumors is, you know, I'm gonna give my famous example. And I don't know, you know, I was looking at it the other day. Hot Singles Near You still exists. That was a tremendous podcast. You know, creatively, things sometimes have a shelf life and they come to an end. But that was great. That shit was great. And I remember one time me and Alexa were talking about, in the middle of that podcast, kind of soon after or before, we saw one of my favorite rappers ever, Isaiah Rashad. Isaiah Rashad had some, like, gay or bi rumors, you know what I mean? And you know what sucks is just, like, there's nothing... It's like, nobody really cares about being gay. And everyone knows there's nothing wrong with being gay. But if you're a rapper, generally, you're putting on this fucking heavy masculine persona about how much pussy you get. And the only guy who's done rapped about fucking sucking dicks is Kevin Abstract. But that's, like, his whole thing. That's, like, his whole thing. And I feel like, you know, if I say Rashad's a gay man or a bi man in his free time, I think he's comfortable with that. But whether he wants to make his rap about that, you know, is on him. And I feel like that decision was taken away from him. Just like it was taken away from Meek Mill, right? And what is he going to do? What is he going to do? If he goes out and says, I'm not, it's going to seem like he is. Like nothing, because you're just fucked in that situation. You're just fucked. Lean in. Lean into it, dude. Do some gay rap, dude. Put out an album with Isaiah Rashad and Kevin Abstract, produced by P. Diddy. Well, I'm, unless he's like a pedophile or something, or a predator. But he's like the Black Harvey Weinstein is fucking P. Diddy. That's so embarrassing. There's nothing. It's not embarrassing. It just stinks. That just stinks, right? It's fun. Is that, why do we live in this fucking upside down world where all of our masculine icons only became that way because they're gay and they had to fake it? You know what I mean? And then I liked fucking Yu-Gi-Oh cards in high school and everyone's like, you're gay. And I'm like, I'm not. I'm fucking not. I remember, listen, there's two reasons why when I realized it was okay to be gay. All right? I was afraid. When I was a strapping young lad who didn't know about being gay or didn't know any gay people, I was afraid of being gay. I didn't know. I really was. I didn't know how it worked. But two things got me out of it. One, Macklemore, same love. Hey, Macklemore, thanks for that. Thanks for that. I didn't know drawing made you not gay. Drawing makes you not. You could draw and be straight. You know what I mean? And also, I would play Yu-Gi-Oh! And people would be like, you're gay. And gay is like an abstract concept. But eventually I realized, you know, if dudes give you boners, you're gay. But if you're just playing Yu-Gi-Oh! In a food court, you're a nerd. It's different. And then same love hit, and I'm like, what am I worried about? What the flip am I worried about? I'm not worried about anything. Meek Mill, honestly, don't be worried. You should do a song with Macklemore. You should do Macklemore and Isaiah Rashad and Kevin Abstract. Same Love, Part 2. What? Same Love, Part 2. The love is even samer. Same Love is kind of a funny. I just talked about being gay for, how long has this been? How long has this been? I've been talking for 10 minutes now. You know, it's a funny thing. It is a funny detail. You know, and once again, the solo pods are for people who really, really want to get the idea of what's going on in my head. You know, this guy's looking at me. I'm talking on the phone. This guy's, you really want to get good. Well, I'm gonna drop some secrets on the pod. And I don't know why I fucking do this, but, you know, I don't do comedy at Helium all the time. I do it sometimes. But almost every time I do, for some reason, the moment before I leave the house, I make some sort of bold fashion choice. And by bold, I mean bold for me. And by bold, I mean the wrong choice, always, dude. I'm a sweaty guy. I sweat, all right? And I'll tell you why. I'm just going to, secret time, not so secret time. Last year, at Philly's Funniest, you know, I usually wear dark shirts, dark concealing shirts, two-layered shirts. I'm going to go like a fucking, and I'm going to go a light blue shirt. I've never made it through a drive in my life without a pit stain. And I'm like, I'm going to wear, and you know, there's like this like small time window to get to Philly's Funniest, whatever. Show up in this bright blue shirt, sopping wet. And I performed my set with little paper towels tucked under my arms. My shoulders must have seemed so rigid. There was so much moisture. There was so much moisture! Sorry, I screamed that at a Chinese lady. There was so much moisture coming out of my body. And I made a rule last year at Philly's Funniest. I said, no more performing in light shirts. You're only going to perform in dark shirts from now on. And for the most part, I have stuck to this rule. But then today, I'm gonna go to the Helium open mic. It's 5:30. I'm gonna go to the Helium open mic. I put on a white shirt. And then I'm in my car, and I literally watched myself do it again. I was like, am I feeling a little damp already? And then I thought to myself, no, you're good. And then I thought, no, this is why you always do this. This is why you always do this. Go put on a fucking black t-shirt. You know what? Because I'm like, oh, what am I going to be, a black t-shirt guy? Go fuck myself. I'm going to go fuck myself. All right? For that negative self-talk. Have you ever told yourself to go fuck yourself? I don't think I ever have. Before today. But, I think I said in the street, I said, no fucking way. And I went in and I put on my nice black shirt. I'm gonna do a bold, what is this bold fashion choice? That's how you know I'm not gay. My friends would always say, because and gay people have said this to me too. Because anybody who's ever called me gay is usually a straight people. Both gays and women know there's no way. I literally have no fashion sense at all. Zero. Although, I mean, any fashion I wear, I've been wearing my girlfriend's clothes. That's gay. My girlfriend's got a nice drip, dude. You know what she got me for my birthday? She got me this nice Dora the Explorer hat. And it rocks. And I'm rocking it to heel. See, like, that's the bold fashion choice, but... Man. I'm looking at like a non-binary nun right now. That's fascinating. Wouldn't it be funny if none of this was recorded? I see the red light. I would kill myself if none of this got recorded. Who says that? It's David Lynch. He's like, you ever forget an idea and you just want to fucking kill yourself? Well, here's another idea. What if I change the name of the pod? I always said I would or could. Jakey's pod, it's fine. It's funny. Everybody calls me Jakey now, like, which is kind of funny. What if I call the podcast Meditations with Jake Lipinski? And we can meditate on it. Or at least maybe the solo episodes could be meditations or whatever. What's tonight? Meditations on Tuesday Night Comedy with Jake Lipinski. Yeah, like, let me, there's so much fresh hip stuff going on in the city. There's, Ortliebs, there's Helium, early, for the middle slot, you got Gold Grape Room, it's on its way out, but for a little bit longer, I gotta go to every single Grape Room, because I don't want to miss it, and I heard Connor Lutz is gonna pick up Silas P on the last one. I heard that, from somebody. Somebody told me. And then after that, Adam Flick and Charlie Gibson end up this new mic at Brownies, which I think is tremendous. And then after that, good old baby Two Street. Good old baby Two Street. Old Two Street coming in. Old Two Street coming in clutch. The old late night start. Tonight, we got John Caldwell and... Steve Neely hosting tonight. Against my wishes. Oh, I think people, I'm driving past Helium now. I don't want to see anybody I know see me talking to myself. Against my wishes, Steve Neely has signed up for the open mic. Is hosting the open mic. But no, I'm just kidding. It's going to be all in good fun. It is once again a test to see if anybody I know or care about has heard this, but you know what's a bit I've been doing? Is when new comics talk to me about Two Street, I give it to them. I say, congratulations, you're running it now. And they just go, no, I can't. And I'm like, no backsies, that's you now, dude. That's you now. They're like, no. I'm like, you have it. This is you. But it's funny for me, it's funny. And the boys don't know this either, but I'm out. If you're listening, I'm out. Hey, if you're listening, I'm out. But I'm going to stay in until somebody kicks me out. I'm just going to... People keep asking me what to do for it. I've been firing off shots. I've been firing off orders. And they said, that's the rule now. If anybody asks me to host, the answer is yes. Except for Neely. That's a no. This is against my wishes. But anybody else, if you ask me to host Two Street, yes. If you ask me to host it forever, yes. Anything, yes. Do you want it? Yes. You can have it. If you're listening to this, if you ever wanted your own fucking open mic to run, you can have it. Oh, Jakey's found a spot. Hold up. Man. And now Jakey's gonna park this car. We don't play. And I'll parallel park it one try. Ooh. I'm gonna say, if a therapist listened to this, I wonder what they would think. I've never seen a therapist because they're bad for you. Guys, this has been Jakey's Pod. I'm gonna go do some comedy. Therapy is bad for you, and have a good night.
He's so cute. Look at the hand. Zoom up on the hand. Go down a little.
No.
Yeah. Whoa, Stompy.
You'll do anything special.
Hi, little. Look at him breathing so hard. You see that belly shaking?
What kind of a creature is it? Look at that guy with a cat.
That could be Ichi, dude. Like, is she also holding a cat? She's holding a cat, too.
That's so funny.
Can we do this, Jake? Yeah. Did you get it really good?
Yeah.
Oh, my God. Let's go follow. And then let's go.